always serving a fresh cup of daily inspiration, Dianna Hobbs.
Today's inspiration is to remind you that God remembers your needs. Sometimes you go through circumstances that indicate that God does not see you, that He has overlooked and forgotten you, but the Lord will never throw you away. He's sending this message to make you mindful of the fact that not only is He aware of your needs, but He has already made provision for every single one of them. Welcome to this, your Tuesday, July 31st, 2018 edition of your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast. My name is Dianna Hobbs. I'm founder of Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, a 501c3 nonprofit organization that distributes free resources all around the world to help you grow in your faith and become everything God has destined you to be. I bring you big smiles and warm greetings live from Empowering Everyday Women Ministry Studios right here in the city of Buffalo, New York. It is currently 68 degrees in the Queen City. It is already the last day in July. Can you believe that? We are headed into August. Where is the year going? I'm grateful though that God has kept you thus far and that He has a special word for us again today. Every single podcast you hear, it is available for you as a free resource. Stream and download it on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher.com, your daily cup of inspiration.com, player.fm, and also on my YouTube channel under my name, Dianna Hobbs, D-I-A-N-N-A-H-O-B-B-S, by hitting that red subscribe button and turning on those notifications. Every time a podcast is uploaded, you will automatically receive a notification. We are going to jump right into today's word, but first a prayer. God our Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for your word. Thank you that you see us and are mindful of us. Thank you for sending this precious person to listen to this podcast today because there's a word for them. So I pray that you will give me what to say so that what I say will be exactly what they need to minister to their spirit. And we thank you, God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Daily Cup family, I remember several years back, I was shopping at Kohl's. I never shop at Kohl's. Still don't, didn't then. But I felt like I needed to go there. And I went inside and I lifted a dress off the rack, took it into the dressing room, tried it on, didn't like it, put it back, went back to browsing. And I felt crazy because I felt like the Holy Spirit had led me to go into Kohl's. About 12 to 15 more minutes passed. I found a few more items to try on. And Daily Cup family, I struck out with every single one. I was exasperated. I said, Lord, why am I here? And I started feeling a bit crazy, but I just could not leave. And so as I was walking out of the fitting room, carrying these unwanted pieces, I heard a voice say, excuse me, are you Miss Hobbs? I was kind of startled, but I looked and smiled and said, yes, hi. And when I walked toward her, it was a young lady named Monica. And she told me that she had been looking for me over 15 years ago. I had met her, but had not seen her since then. And she told me, I just filled out the contact form on your website and left you all my numbers. I've been looking for you forever and I decided to stalk you online. She said, at the lowest point in my life, you were there for me and it was your words that kept me from making the worst decision. You're truly God's woman. I knew I had to find you. So I'm standing in the middle of Kohl's crying, understanding the purpose of God. She really needed to talk. She really needed prayer. She had been looking for me and God told me to go right into Kohl's so that she could run into me. Isn't God mindful of us? He will move heaven and earth to meet your needs. You might not see it right now, but God is always working behind the scenes in your favor. Even if He has to orchestrate a meeting in a department store, He'll do whatever is necessary to reach you. God loves and cares about you so much. I was reading Luke chapter 18, verses 15 through 17, when parents were bringing infants to Jesus so He could just touch them, and the disciples rebuked them. Remember that? But Jesus called the disciples over to Him and said, let the little children come to me. Don't hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of God. And this passage is not only about how we need to be childlike in order to receive the kingdom message and inherit the kingdom of God, but it also shows Christ's compassion and how He would never, ever turn anyone away, even those who would ordinarily be overlooked. I was reading Nehemiah 7 also, and it focuses on some of God's children who felt invisible and overlooked in the Old Testament. And this is really going to minister to you if you're going through a season where you feel like God is not cognizant, or he's not aware, or he's not paying attention to your situation, even though you know he always pays attention. Sometimes it feels like he doesn't, right? Well, after the walls and gates of Jerusalem had been rebuilt, the Jews had returned home from Babylonian captivity, and they were trying to resettle in their community. And some of the people had accurate written records of themselves and families. Others didn't. So there was not a hint of proof of their identities anywhere. Some who were priests weren't listed. That meant they couldn't serve in the priestly capacity because they couldn't prove who they were. Suddenly, people who had an identity were anonymous and unknown. And this had to be frustrating, and they must have felt helpless. But according to verse 65, there were some instructions given to the priests that had no records, no credentials, or verifications. The Bible says that the governor ordered them not to eat any of the most sacred food until there should be a priest ministering with the Urim and Thummim. The Urim and Thummim were in the breastplates of the priestly garments, according to Exodus 28 and 30, and this was the way they consulted with God to discern his will. So here in this passage, we learn something. Once priests took time to commune with the Lord, it was fully expected that he would speak and reveal the true identities of the ones who were anonymous to man. I love this so much, because this passage teaches us something. People may not know who you are, and they may not care, but God does. He's aware of everything about you. He sees and is concerned about the smallest and most intricate details of our lives. Luke 12 and 7 says the very hairs on your head are numbered. In Ezekiel 16, God shows a metaphor about how in ancient times, when somebody didn't want a baby, they took the baby, threw the baby out in the open field, and let animals eat the baby's flesh. And God compares Israel to that abandoned child in Ezekiel 16, beginning at verse 4. He says, "As for your nativity on the day you were born, your navel cord was not cut, nor were you washed in water to cleanse you. You were not rubbed with salt," and that's how they disinfected back then. "You were not wrapped in swaddling cloth, but you were thrown out into the open field when you yourself was loathed on the day you were born." And God says, "And when I passed by you and saw you struggling in your own blood, I said to you in your blood, live. Yes, I said to you in your blood, live. I made you thrive like a plant in the field. You grew and matured and became very beautiful." This metaphor is incredible because it shows that even though others, even though life, even though circumstances may cast you aside, God never casts you aside. He sees every one of your needs. He has a purpose for your life, to raise you up, to lift you up and make you somebody for him. Today, this word is special. It is tailor-made. It is customized for the one that has been in a space where it can get so dark sometimes, and the uncertainty about your future is great. You don't know what God is doing or what he's up to. Sometimes you pray and it feels like those prayers are bouncing right off the sky, but God is saying, "I hear you. I see you. I love you. I have not turned you away. I have not thrown you away. You might be anonymous to others, but you are not anonymous to me. I know the plans I have for you," as he said in Jeremiah 29:11. "They're plans to prosper you, to give you a hope and a future. So lift your head up today. There's an incredible plan God has for your life. He will restore you. He will elevate you. He will increase you. He will heal you. He will comfort you. Whatever your needs are today, he will provide." To remind you that God remembers your needs, I'm stirring Matthew 6 and 26 in the New International Version in your cup of inspiration, and it says, "Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they?" As you drink down the contents of your cup, remember that if God feeds the birds of the air and looks after them, he will take care of you. You are in the palm of his hand. He will never leave nor forsake you. You are his prized possession, and he will sustain you. When you are crying in the midnight hour and your pillow is wet with tears, he bottles those tears up. None of your pain is wasted. He will use it for the kingdom. But know this today, that he sees you, and he is already implementing a plan to rescue you from your despair. So hang in there, lift up your head. God, who is the King of Glory has already come in. He has rushed to your defense, and everything will be all right. God remembers you. Now let's pray. God, I pray for this, my sister, this, my brother. Thank you for reminding them that you see them, you know them. Every concern, every worry, every care they have, we give it to you right now. As they place their trust in you, every way is made, every door is open, and every promise is fulfilled. According to your will, we count it done by faith. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast has been brought to you by Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, where we help fuel your faith every day. For more information, log on to www.deannahobbs.com.